Welcome to another episode of My Kitchen Intuition podcast and video series. It is a pleasure to have you here today on this new video, where it's so exciting for me because I'm going to talk about Peruvian cuisine staples. What are the staples of Peruvian cuisine? We have so many. I'm just gonna talk about my favorite ones because I think, and I'm gonna talk briefly about it because if I talk about them, probably I will take a few hours for a video. So I don't know as many as you know. Peru has over 3,000 varieties of potatoes. It is amazing. We have all kinds of colors, all kinds of textures, and all kinds of flavors for the potatoes. I think you'll never end up tasting them. And not too many people know that actually potatoes are originally from Peru. And they were brought to Europe by the Spaniards when they came into the country, the conquistadors. And we just have so many dishes with potatoes, and we use other Peruvian staples to actually make delicious potato dishes. And it's just so good. It's just very, very good. I mean, we have these like sweet potatoes, but then we have also like a lower seed sweet potato that we use for ceviche in there. And it's just really unbelievable. We have dried potatoes where we make that dish called carpulcra, one of my best dishes. And that goes, it's a dry potato that gets actually hydrated with, we'll say beef stock or chicken stock. And it's just so good. It's a very wholesome, delicious dish. Also, if that many didn't know about that, tomatoes are originally from Peru. And even though we might think they come from Europe, Italy, they were brought to Europe by the Spaniards. And during the French Revolution, it was given them to the people that were in prison because they thought they were poisonous. So they thought they wanted them to die by eating tomatoes that actually came from the Americas. And so tomatoes are actually originally from Peru. So this is so many things. I'm so proud I'm Peruvian because a lot of people don't know about this. And I do believe that this information needs to be out more. Another ingredient that I love is quinoa. Quinoa has become very popular around the world in the last few years. And pretty much I grew up eating quinoa. Quinoa is the mother grain. That's how they used to call during the Inca times in Peru. But it's just amazing. It's an amazing ingredient. In that it doesn't only grow in Peru, it grows in Bolivia, Ecuador, and Peru. And it's just such a nutritious ingredient. It's gluten-free, it's the favorite for vegetarians and vegans because it has a lot of protein and it has a lot of nutrients, a lot of amino acids, and it's really antioxidant ingredient. And it's so versatile because quinoa can actually be cooked as an appetizer, which the previous video that I made these quinoa croquettes, and they are really good with this tomato, avocado salsa. It's just delicious, and it's a healthy way to have an appetizer. It can also be cooked as a main dish. Sometimes for my friends or for my clients, I will make this quinoa stew with roasted veggies. It is delicious. We add other Peruvian staples that I will talk a little bit later for it to give it more flavor. It's just very, very good. And you can actually make either quinoa pancakes if you want to talk about breakfast, you know, some dark chocolate and quinoa, and you make pancakes out of that. And also you can make a dessert like a quinoa porridge. You know, it's just so many ways to use quinoa. And another ingredient, you know, I'm so happy that it comes from Peru, the country I'm from. And it's just amazing. Another great ingredient is corn. We have a variety of corn in Peru. We have all colors of corn. My favorite is the regular white corn that you use for ceviche. And sometimes when we make the rice, white rice in Peru, we add that corn to it. And it just gives a little bit of crunch, you know, to the corn. because the corn in Peru are really big and meaty, and they are not as sweet. It can actually be used for a lot of savory dishes. We also make tamales out of dried corn, and that is just unbelievable. I love it. I have made tamales before. It's amazing. It's really, really good. We also have another type of tamal that is called humitas, which is the sweeter version of a tamal, and it's just unbelievable. That's sweeter, and it's sweeter and savory, so the flavors are very unique. We also have the purple corn, which it is amazing. It has so many healthy properties. We make chicha morada with that, and it's just unbelievable. We make this dish called chicha morada, as I was saying before, and it's really a staple in restaurants. It's really good if you pair it with ceviche, because it's the freshness of the chicha, which is actually made with pineapple rind, green apple or quince, and cinnamon and cloves. So you get all these spices, you know, when you cook it, that beautiful smell that comes when you make the chicha is just unbelievable. And that is actually a staple of restaurants, but also when I was growing up, it was a staple at the birthday parties with my family, because I remember my mom or my grandmother, my aunts, having big pots, you know, making the chicha morada. And actually, out of the chicha morada, you make a mazamorra, which is like a dessert that you make with this, a porridge. And it goes with pineapple and dried fruits in there. It's just so, so good. This type of corn is amazing. It's unbelievable. It has so many healthy properties. It's a great aid for the to heal cancer. It's great to lose weight. It has so many antioxidants. It's a beautiful ingredient. And we also have another type of corn where we make actually beer corn, whatever you say that. And it's called chicha de jora, which actually is, it reminds me a little bit of apple cider vinegar, but it's not. This is a corn beer, and it's used a lot to drink. A lot of people drink it, and I actually get drunk from it. Or you can use it to cook, like lamb stews or beef stews. It's just so unbelievable. It's a unique flavor. I don't think you can find it anywhere else other than from that chicha de jora. And I will totally recommend people to really research more into that, or I can always do an episode about that. Another ingredient that I love, that I think it gives the name of Peruvian food, that is actually available now in the United States. When I came to this country, we can only find it canned, and you couldn't really grow it here because I'm in the East Coast, so the winter, I mean, we just got trouble problem growing that, which is Peruvian peppers, ají peppers. And we have so many varieties of that too. We have a specific one for ceviche, ají amarillo, ají panca. So I'm gonna start with the ají amarillo, which is the one we make dishes such papa la huancaína or causa. And this pepper is just amazing because I am Peruvian, but I don't like too spicy foods. I like a little hint of spiciness, and this pepper is perfect for that, because it has this fruity flavor, but at the end has that bit of spiciness. It's like it gives you a kick at the end, and it's just so delicious. And you can find it everywhere now. You can find it even in Amazon. They come frozen from Peru, and but it's easily available right now to find anywhere. You can actually, my winner, ceviche of shrimp and artichoke ceviche, is my leche de tigre is made with ají amarillo, and I will say the rest of the ingredients because it's a secret. But it's just it's an amazing pepper. It just has a distinct flavor to that you can add into your foods. Another pepper is ají panca, which is this red pepper that is sun-dried, and it's a smoky flavor. If you add it into roasting, if you, normally when I make my chicken skewers, I add that to that because it just gives it a flavor that nobody really knows, and it's just so good that people always ask, what is it? And also to any kind of stew, or you want to grill something, you can use it too. You know, it's just amazing. It just gives that smokiness to, you know, what you either want to roast or, you know, how you want to cook it. You can actually cook this kind of pepper in high heat without worrying that your food is going to burn or the pepper is going to burn itself. Another one is ají mirasol, which is the ají amarillo that actually is sun dry also. And when it's sun dry, the pepper got smoky, and you can hydrate it with water, and you can actually also use it for stews and to give it a little bit of that ají amarillo flavor, but with that smokiness in there too. It's just unbelievable. And then we have other ones too that, you know, we use for ceviche. Oh my God, we have such a variety of peppers, but these are the ones that are the staple that we use the most in our cuisine, and I really, really love and I recommend. So I just wanted to give you a little bit of the Peruvian staples, what we really, is our everyday that we use all the time. Like, if we have ceviche, we have to have the corn, you know, and if we make potato causa, which is a type of a potato dish where gets a stuff with anything you want, like from shrimp and crab meat, you know, chicken, whatever you want, really. I actually make causa for a cooking class I taught a few weeks ago, and I topped it with octopus and with olive aioli. It was so delicious. It was very, like, people were like, wow, when they tasted it. So it's many ways that you can use that. Ají amarillo is just beautiful, is, you know. And all these ingredients have, like, their own healing properties, you know, like quinoa and the purple corn. Even the peppers have great anti-inflammatory properties. They are really good. Spicy foods can really help, you know, with inflammation. They have really good properties for that. So, you know, this is what really identifies Peru. Of course, there are many other ingredients that I will talk in other episodes, but I just wanted to bring this a little bit of history and information, especially in regards of the potato and the tomatoes and where they're coming from. And just for to give you some knowledge of the ingredients, and you can find Peruvian ingredients in any Latin American store. And if you go to my website, I have a link there in Amazon where you can get the Peruvian ingredients, and it'll be easier for you to get it shipped right to your door. And I just have fun with it. Have fun, you know, try the ingredients. If you wanna, you can either buy the whole peppers and then make a paste yourself, or if you go to any store, you can find actually jar paste already, ready to go. So it'll be easier for you just to really try. And there's one pepper that I forgot, which is the hottest pepper, but I use it for my regular leche de tigre for my ceviche clásico. I cannot miss it. I just remember about that, and I cannot miss it, which is rocoto pepper. I gave it to a friend yesterday that loves spicy foods. It's just spicy, but it has a lot of flavor. So if you're really into spicy foods, try rocoto. It is amazing, has a lot of flavor and a lot of spice, a lot of heat. So if you want to learn more about Peruvian cuisine, you want to learn how to cook Peruvian cuisine, which is an amazing exotic cuisine, and if you want to have more information or learn how to cook just simple foods, and maybe we can add a touch of the Peruvian cuisine or maybe a dinner or something, let me know. My website is mykitchenintuition.com. I would love for you to subscribe to get more information about this and a lot more of other things that can be really good for you, including Peruvian food, of course. Please subscribe, share, and share it with people that you love, And if you want to know more about what are the services that I offer, you can go to my website, www.mykitchenintuition.com. Thank you so much again for being here and taking the time to watch this video. I hope it was very informational to you, and I'll see you next time. Signing off, this is MaritaLynn with My Kitchen Intuition. Thank you so much.